Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today we'll be looking at Luminar Neo and we'll be using it to edit this lighthouse photograph that I took up at Flamborough Head. We're going to focus on the essentials inside of Luminar Neo. Before I forget though, if you like my videos, please click the like button down below, and if you'd like to see more, please click subscribe. That'll help my channel out a lot. So in this demonstration, I will be using the early access version of Luminar Neo. It's version 0.9.3. So this is not the production version of Neo. It does have quite a few bugs still left in it that they have to work out before they go to production. It is good value for money. I think it's about $65 for a license compared to something like Adobe Lightroom and Photoshop, where you have to pay a monthly subscription fee. And it does actually do an excellent job. As you can see here, we have my lighthouse picture that I brought in here. For those of you who've used Luminar AI, this is going to be very familiar to you, but we still have the crop AI up here at the top where we can tell it to crop the picture and it will automatically come up with a crop that it thinks is appropriate for this picture. We can select ratios here. We can go freeform. We can stay original. Where we were at, transposed. We can go into like 4x5 or 8.5x11 or whatever the case may be that you want to do. We can automatically align the horizon. We can flip the picture around inside of the crop. We can flip it from left to right, and we can flip it upside down and right side up. So it gives us quite a few features. And as usual, inside of Luminar products, in the top right hand corner of the tool, if we decide we're not going to use any of these edits that we just made, we just click this back and it takes us back to it sets all of our edits that we've made back to where they were when we started. Now our next item in essentials is develop. And under develop, this is where we control our exposure, smart contrast, highlight, shadows, color curves, sharpness, noise reduction, all this sort of thing. We're going to go past this and go down to Enhance AI. So Enhance AI has two sections to it. The Accent AI, which will control the whole picture, and the Sky Enhancer, which focuses on the sky. These are the part of the AI features inside of the Luminar products. It goes through and makes a whole bunch of different adjustments based on like the highlights, the contrast, vibrance, all these sorts of controls. So as we crank up the Accent AI, the AI goes through, and as you can see, it's brightening the foreground. And if I crank it all the way over to the right, I've got more contrast over here in the sky. I brighten my foreground. It's added some contrast in there. So if I'm going to leave that all the way cranked up just for this demo. And if I crank the sky, what it's doing is it's dimming the sky down. And since it knows it's sky, it's adding blue. But as you can see, what it's doing is it's bringing this light out for me as well. And if I zoom in here, I mean, I've got pretty good. It's a lighthouse, right? I've got high dynamic range inside of this picture. Light's very bright. Sky's very dark. But it seems to deal really well with it. So I've got kind of what I'm after here. Now, I'm going to leave that all the way up. Now, with most Luminar products, and we're not going to use any masking this demo, we're just going through and showing the sliders. I can click on this button here. It will take me back and show me what the picture looks like without that edit on. We have an erase function down here. Now, for those of you who are new to Luminar Neo, we have this remove power lines and remove, oh, they went away, but there's a remove dust spots. So if I had dust spots on my sensor and it showed up in my picture, it'll go through and automatically find those and remove them. And I don't have any on this picture, so I'm not going to worry about it, but it does a really good job. And the remove power lines, it does a fairly good job as well. Light glare that showed up there, we just highlight it, click on it, and tell it to erase. And it erases it. Does a fairly good job. You can see some remnants that we would normally come back in here and clean up. But it's does a fairly good job if I was erasing things. So, for example, if I wanted to remove this section of this building right here, I could just highlight that Let's say I don't want that sign there either. I can highlight that, click on erase, give it a second for the AI to come in and do its thing. And it's gone. I've got some remnants left, but it doesn't look too horribly bad. So that's the erase function. I'm not going to go through and use any erase on this one. Now we have structure. And so what structure is doing is it's adding sharpness and clarity. And you can tell if we crank this all the way up, this is what we get. It has a very HDR feel to it, like the old HDR. And so it's a kind of a very grunge, but I want to add a little bit. You can see it's adding a little bit more detail, clarity down in the picture. Now the boost focuses on the smaller details. As you can see, it does a whole lot in this foreground where this harvested field is in front of me. So I'm just going to bring that up just a hair, not too much. Now the next one down we have in here is color. So we can change the vibrance and the saturation. In this picture, we don't really want to add any more saturation because all it's going to do is put a lot more blue back in the sky, nor do I want to add a whole lot of vibrance because it's going to do the same thing. What I do want to do, though, is probably remove some of the color cast where I've got this blue. I could remove most of the color cast and get kind of my sky back to looking like this, which is more realistic. The sky wasn't really that blue that night. It was overcast. It was gray, to be honest with you. But the picture, the capture with the light and everything, because I've got some lights from Scarborough in the background here. If I come in here with HSL, I've got my normal HSL stuff where I can adjust hue and saturation and luminance for each color channel. This is pretty common, so if I go to saturation and I want to increase saturation in the yellow just a little bit, and then in the orange just a hair, and maybe in the reds. Is reds really? Yep, reds affecting the field again right in front of me here. So I will leave that with the HSL. Now, black and white. If we're going to convert this image into black and white, we would just click on convert black and white, and then we could adjust inside of here for the colors. As you can see, as I bring this up, the luminance on the red, I can adjust that. I can adjust luminance in the yellow. And so this is for bringing down the different color spectrums in your original picture once you convert it to black and white. You can also come back into saturation and so I can add saturation back in after I've converted this into black and white and get some really cool effects. For example, I mean, I've increased the red. I've got a little bit of red on the field in front of me, but if I increase the yellow, would have expected more in the light, but I get a little bit in the light and a little bit in the field in front of me if I bring the green magenta. So I can do stuff like this where I'm bringing back the color in just certain parts of the picture after I've converted it into black and white. Pretty cool stuff there. Now the details, I've got large, small, and medium details that I brought out. I don't really want to over sharpen this particular picture, and I'm pretty happy with where I'm at. I mean, so if I were to zoom in and I adjust large details, it's going to focus on the larger bits in the picture. I can bring out more detail. Now, so you got to be careful with the small detail. It's going to add a lot of, it's going to make the picture feel very grungy, if you will. In this case, I'm dealing with a lighthouse. I'm dealing at night. I don't really want to add a lot of detail because all my detail additions are just going to add more noise to my picture. And I've shot with a high ISO, so I already have a lot of noise in this picture, so I really don't want to add any more. And you can tell, if I turn that feature off by clicking on the little eye up there, you can see how much noise you're adding into a nighttime picture whenever you're trying to add more clarity, and you're not really adding a lot of clarity. You're just adding a heck of a lot of noise. So I'm going to back all that back out, but just so that you're aware that it is there. Now we're going to save denoise for last. After I've done all my edits, I'll come back in and do the denoise. Landscape, if I was doing a landscape photography or a photograph, which is kind of is, I mean, I can add some golden hour effects, and I do kind of like that. It brings out the yellow in the light, the yellow in the field. Might leave that in there. So that's before and after. So dehaze is going to take some of the blue out. I'm just going to leave that like it is. And I can do the spoilage enhancer down here, which is going to bring out green. So the problem, the thing you got to watch for with the spoilage enhancer is like so many other things, if you crank this up all the way, it's going to overdo it. So this is where I'm starting at. I can add a little bit more into the greens there. Pretty happy with that. My advanced setting, I've got my hue foliage. I can change the hue on the foliage to be whatever I want. I'm probably just going to keep it in this range here to go with the evening sky that I was shooting in. And the final thing is we have a vignette. I can choose a subject, which is actually the light on the lighthouse. And then I can drop these hues down like this, or I can go the other way and make it lighter. What I'm going to do is just add a little bit. I can bring it in or push it out as close as I want. We're going to push it out. We just want a little bit of vignetting on there. The creative tools, some of the other features, and in this particular one, I just wanted to show you this. There's the Relight AI, which is new to Luminar Neo, and it does some pretty cool stuff. We can change the lighting effects in the foreground and in the background. Let's try bringing the light up in the foreground. And as you can see, I mean, if I slide this slider over, it will light up the foreground really well. We're just going to add a little bit of that. And then if I go and add up the lighting in the background, it's going to blow the background up like that for me. I can change the depth. So if you will, if you can see like this shadow that's passing from the foreground to the background as I adjust this depth. I'm going to leave it somewhere in that neighborhood. I really don't want to bring. The other side of this is I can bring the brightness down near me, which I don't really want to do. I want to leave that up. I can bring it down in the background and get something like that, which is probably more of what I'm after. I'm trying to accent this light here. So I've got my foreground, I got my light, and adjust this depth where I can bring a little bit more light onto the lighthouse. So I can, so as you can see, I slide it down, it brings it back into the foreground. As I slide it out, it slides it back into the background there. And so I'm probably gonna stay with that. And my final thing here is I'm going to come back into denoise, and if I zoom in, actually my noise isn't incredibly bad, but I can come back in here, remove a little bit more noise. Okay, so that is editing this lighthouse at Flamborough Head with Luminar Neo. The last thing I didn't show you was over here with the exposure. So we got blacks, whites, curves. What I do like to do, I could add a little bit of an S-curve in here. I got to be careful bringing up the top, though, and the highlights, even though I'm dropping down into the shadows. Reason being is I don't want to blow my light in the lighthouse completely out any farther than I had to when I took the picture. So we can do the S-curve in here. We got our blacks and whites, sharpness, color. We have new noise reduction in here. So that's our lighthouse at Flamborough Head. You can see our before and our after picture. We've got a really good, we've brought out the light really well on this one. We've kind of adjusted our foreground lighting. We've worked our way through the essentials inside of Luminar Neo. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please give me a like and subscribe down below, and I will be presenting some more of these Luminar Neo videos in the next few weeks to kind of go over some of the creative, and then we'll revisit the portrait and the professional settings as well inside of Luminar Neo. Hope you enjoyed this. If you did, give me a like I said, down below, and leave comments. I do appreciate you watching my video today, and I'll see you next time. Thanks. Bye.